Shalom. Giving all honor, praise, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Kakwadash. Double honor to our apostles and elders, great millstone, every well. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect, pushing the true doctrine across the four winds of the earth and all truth and in sincerity. I'm Lamar Ariyah from the Mississippi camp. Lord willing, to be edifying lesson. And this is a GMS quick hit in transit. And it's just, you know, just going into conversations that came up in the shop today. You know, it seemed like in the shop and, you know, at a store before I got ready to leave out to head to camp. But this topic was going into how people got cancer, man. Everybody getting cancer, especially amongst Israel. You know, how cancer is been, you know, sending a lot of people to the spirit world, man. I mean, really deleting a lot of the nation of Israel. And we know we under the curses. Well, those of us in the know we're under the curses, okay? Those of us in the truth. But the curses run deep, man. And Jake, our people, Israel, are being destroyed by cancer, man, amongst other diseases, man. You know, heart disease, right? Of course, cancer, diabetes. You know, Jake getting all these STDs. Then, you know, Esau tops it off with poisoning the food, poisoning the air, poisoning the water, poisoning the music, sending out all this witchcraft, you know, these spells through the music. The scripture goes into the whole earth is defiled and how we shall eat our bread defiled. And we see it. We see it, man. And it's getting to the point now that your average everyday Jake is noticing particular things, man. And one of those things, like I say, conversations kept coming out throughout the day, is the food, man. How the food is destroying people, man. Destroying our people. Because the hormones they putting in it. Okay, you know, I was talking to my brother-in-law today, and you know, he's a maintenance man at Tyson, and they're getting ready to tomorrow delete thousands of chickens, man, because they are too big. But why are they too big? Because they pumping them full of these hormones, you know, all these different chemicals and shit for production sake. Unnatural, you know, just the wicked left-handed way of doing things for money, trying to get money, production, trying to pump out all these chickens that are not going through a natural state of growing, but being enhanced by shooting them up, steroids and hormones and all that. And then people consume these the items and consume this food, because they do it with the cows, okay? They do it with the poultry, beef, even fucking pork. Though we don't supposed to eat pork, it's unlawful. We, nobody in this truth, no Israelite should be eating no pork, especially if you're in the truth. But they're even poisoning the poisonous food anyway. So Israel fucked up, man. So I'm talking to another client today, and he's talking about he's finna cook up some raccoon, a coon, for Thanksgiving. And I'm, you know, our people go from bad to worse, man. You know, it's bad enough the food is poisonous, the food is not nutritional, You know, but Jake still go out their way to do or eat or consume abominable foods, man. But the scripture said, what, our people the wise to do evil, but to do good they have no knowledge. So he's gonna cook up a coon, so he's finna get a double whammy, a double fucking whammy of abomination. Cause he's gonna be talking about doing a wild hog. So this nigga talk about a coon, a wild hog, and then he probably gonna have regular shit that normally be ate on Thanksgiving, turkey, you know, dressing and all that shit that's already been processed by Esau, injected with all kind of abomination. It's really just, it's crazy, man. And people would sit up and look at the Lord's prophets like we're crazy for going down the highways and byways, sighing and crying, okay? Prophesying, because we want this place to come to an end. We want Yahweh Shai to return and destroy this place, set up a righteous kingdom. Because this kingdom, under the rule of this devil, Esau, even the so-called white man, promotes death, institutionalized death, okay? They push death. You know, it's nothing pro-life. Everything is pro-death. You know, if brothers just go Google the ingredients in any item in America versus in Europe or Russia or whatever, the content when it comes to ingredients, it'll blow your mind. You know, these other countries, you know, they like, for instance, Europe, they'll have, like, let's say, a Coke, you know, a Coca-Cola, because that's one I had looked up, a Fanta, some shit. But anyway, it may have 5 or 6 items, ingredients used to produce that drink, right? But when you look at what America has in their ingredients for that same drink, the same item, they got like, what, a fucking paragraph of items of different ingredients, man. Shit you can't pronounce. And, you know, so you gotta be like, why? What's the difference? Why would they put so much more ingredients in that shit versus these other countries? Because a lot of these other countries ban these things, these particular ingredients, where they can't be put in consumable foods or drinks that people are actually gonna ingest. Because it causes cancer, because it causes diabetes, because it causes autism, you know, fatigue, obesity. It's not healthy. But yet and still, America, our people in America, Babylon, do not try to be health conscious, change the diet. You know, none of us are perfect, okay? We all fuck up, including myself. And I'm speaking myself first and foremost, you know? But just like in this truth, we supposed to push to better ourselves, man, when it comes to our health, okay? The way we just move in general, you know? But definitely when it comes to our health, what we eat. We try to eat the best of the worst. And we always pray over our food, man. Because at the end of the day, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai preserving us, man. Because this food we eat, man, we should have been through and done. Deleted in the spiritual world, because we're eating poison. We're drinking poison. We're breathing poison, man. So let me stop just ragging on. Let me get some scriptures. I'm going to close it out. But we need Yahweh Shai to return, man, because this place under this rulership, the way this earth is being run, you're on death row. Just waiting for you to drop dead, man. Just waiting for your time to drop. This is Deuteronomy 28, starting at verse 58. If thou shalt not observe to do all the words of this law that are written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name, the Lord Yahweh, thy power. And this is going into the curses, the things that we would have to deal with that would come upon us if we didn't obey the things from the first verse to the 14th verse. Okay? But when you read down to 15, it tells you about the things that is going to happen if we didn't obey. Right? So back in the scripture, that verse 59, then the Lord Yahweh will make thy plagues wonderful. And the plagues of thy seed, even great plagues, and of long continuance, and sore sickness, and long continuance. And these plagues, man, plagues are you know, sicknesses, evil shit, okay? And our people go through all this kind of shit, man. And, you know, I'm going into, like, the different sicknesses, infirmities, you know, cancer, heart disease, obesity, colon cancer, you name it, man. Lung problems, asthma, you know, it's the curses because our disobedience, man. But a lot of our people don't understand the reason we're going through this stuff. The reason where this is happening, because this is a plague the Lord brought upon us for our disobedience, man. All these different diseases, man. The Lord is allowing this devil to have all the sugars in these food, all these different chemicals in the food, spraying chemtrails throughout the air. Okay? This is judgment, man. Verse 60. Moreover, he will bring upon thee all the diseases of Egypt which thou wast afraid of, and they shall cleave unto thee. So all the plagues that was upon Egypt are going to happen again in some kind of shape, form, or fashion. Whether it's, you know, floods, or, you know, locusts come eating up all the crops, or hailstorms, tornadoes, earthquakes. It's gonna come, right? It's gonna happen again on a wider scale. And every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of the law, then will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed. And you don't read about gout. You don't read about heart disease, cancer, diabetes in the scriptures. Okay? You don't read about brain tumors, blood clots. You know? These things are not just really written about, but these things are, you know, plagues that are happening in today's time that are not written in the scriptures, man. And plagues also are that swore it, man. People's hearts are colder than ever, man. Scripture goes into how the love of many shall wax cold. Mothers killing daughters, daughters killing mothers, fathers killing sons, sons killing fathers. You know, families killing each other, random people killing a random person. You know, it's cold, man. And the worst part about it, it's gonna get worse. It's gonna get a fucking hell of a lot worse. This is just a warm up. the shit we seeing now. You still got law enforcement in place right now. Okay? You still have an active society. You know, when these garbage trucks stop running, when this water stop running, sewage bagging up, you know, it's going to start bringing forth diseases, man. They were talking about in Gaza how the sewage is backing up. That's not good, man. All that feces, then you're going to start getting diseases. Maggots and flies and shit, man, and mosquitoes and shit, then they biting people and carrying that shit, transferring that shit from person to person. You ain't going to have no pharmacy. You're not going to be able to go to the ER. You're not going to be able to go get a tetanus shot or get shot up with some antibiotic or get some antibiotic pills. That's why, hey, the Lord put the spirit on brothers, a lot of the brothers, to learn, understand, and know about the herbs, man. Because Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah gave us medicines that grow from the earth, man. But due to the curses and our disobedience, hey, this is why all this stuff is happening. This is why these conversations are coming up, man. Because the Lord is showing that his words are faithful and true. He's bringing forth these plagues to destroy people, man. These different diseases is judgment from on high. And this is just the beginning. This is the book of 2 Ezra chapter 15, starting in verse 4. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. And a lot of the people who are dying from these diseases, a lot of the people who are really fucked up from these diseases, are not believers of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah. They are faithless people full of incredulity. Now, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah will, you know, put his men through certain obstacles of illnesses, you know, sicknesses. But the difference is, that man is being tried by Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah to test his faith, because he's a servant of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, you know, to make him stronger, to purge him, to purify him, just like Job. Job was a shining, you know, jewel to Yahweh, the Most High Yahweh. And that's just in my words, man. But he was a faithful and servant who of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, who didn't break. And what? The Most High let Satan, you know, have his way with him. Just don't kill him. You know, he couldn't put him to death. So the Lord is also going to put his men through particular purging test. But that's a man of the faith. So that man will have mercy upon him. The Lord will have mercy upon that man if he actually is a chosen of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, an elect man. Okay? But those who are just unfaithful and don't believe and just do as thou wilt and move how they want to move, man, those plagues are going to be a sore destruction, man. The Lord is going to use them plagues to destroy him. Okay? Verse 5, behold, said the Lord Yahweh, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. And this is going to happen too, because Jacob's trouble is still going to come. World War III is going to come. So the whole earth is going to be in straight chaos, man. Survival mode. Okay, it's going to be a cold-hearted land, a cold world, a cold world, yeah. But those who believe in Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, those who have faith in our true service and doing the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah to the best of our ability, Abba Ratazah, us men is true, starting with our apostles and the elders, the great millstone, elder bishops, and brothers, you know, like-minded scattered across the four winds of earth, that we're not only called, but we're chosen, man. Okay? We're going to be good. Verse 6, for wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Because like I say in the beginning, man, this devil has made food, water, and air a war tactic, man, to destroy the people, man. It's starting with you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. And that is just because of the curses, man. The Lord is using this devil to bring forth judgment, man. Okay? To execute judgment on the nation of Israel for being disobedient, hard-headed, stiff-necked, worshiping false idols, okay? Being adulterers, adulteress, just completely wicked, man. So, yeah, I'm all over the place, man, but, you know, we need salvation, man. We need Yahushua to return, man. Because, you know, if this devil continues to do what he do, as the scriptures say, no flesh shall be saved, man. But we know the Lord is going to deliver his elect, man, that remnant, that grape, that cluster, okay, that he has preserved. You know, 144,000 men who would not bow down to Baal, man, but will remain steadfast and unmovable, man, and abide in the word of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. So, hey, Lord willing, this was an edifying lesson. Want to give all honor, praise, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushua, Bahashem, Rekah Kodash. Double honor to our apostles and elders, a great millstone, and well, peace and salutation to the hopeful elect. Shalom.